First of all, it's a big responsibility, especially in a city like Charlotte. So think long and hard before deciding on love. On the other hand, love gives you a sense of security. When walking down the street late at night and you have a leash on love, ain't no one going to mess with you, because crooks and muggers think love is unpredictable. Who knows what love could do in its own defense? On cold winter nights, love is warm. It lies between you and lives and breathes, makes funny noises. Love wakes you up at all hours of the night with its needs. It needs to be fed so it will grow and stay healthy. Love doesn't like being left alone for long. But come home, love is always happy to see you. It may break a few things accidentally in its passion for life, but you can never be mad at love for long. Is love good all the time? No. Love can be bad. Bad love. Very bad love. Love makes messes. Love leaves you little surprises here and there. Love needs a lot of cleaning up after. Sometimes you just want to get love fixed. Sometimes you want to roll up a piece of newspaper and swat love on the nose. Not so much to cause pain, just to let love know, don't you ever do that again. Sometimes love just wants to go out for a nice long walk because love loves exercise. They'll run around the block, leave you panting and breathless, pull you in different directions at once, or wind itself round and around until you are all wound up and cannot move. But love makes you meet people wherever you go. People who have nothing in common but love stop and talk to each other on the street. Throw things away and love will bring them back again, again, and again. But most of all, love needs love. Lots of it. And in return, love loves you. It never stops. I couldn't think of something more apropos for today's celebration, because that's what today is, a celebration. A celebration of love, of commitment, of friendship, of family, of food, of homemade beer, of wine, of plaid shirts, of ironic beards, and most importantly, of two people who are in it forever. You don't have to have the ceremony to have a marriage. And when you think about it, the whole thing's kind of weird, right? For those that have done this before and can remember, you're standing on stage, looking fancy, holding flowers, being stared at by pretty much everyone who has meant something to you in the past 30-something years. So why do we do it? The marriage ceremony has been an important feature that's transcended across every community.
I'm in love with our little family, and I've really never felt so good. Today, I promise to always support you in your dreams, and to always work to help you achieve them. I promise to listen to your fears, as well as your hopes, and to be someone you can lean on just as annoying as you. But mostly, I promise to love you, no matter what. You are my love, you're my life.
Now, Mr. Murphy, the floor is yours.
I'm going to be a little bit.
We now reach that portion of the ceremony where the couple declares their intent for each other. And again, we place first. Shelby, you take Sean to be your husband, partner in crime, in the adventure that lies ahead. You walk by his side to the ends of the earth to encourage and to support him in every way and every endeavor. To sample all of his beers and enjoy his cornucopia of smoked meat. You commit to opening yourself up completely to him and share with him your entire being, to share in the laughter as well as the tears, to love and to cherish him until death or something you are. Sean, do you take Shelby to be your wife and partner in crime in the adventure that lies ahead, to walk by her side to the ends of the earth, to encourage her and support her in every way and in every endeavor, to partake in endless hours of B-flick horror movies and watch countless off-the-wall YouTube clips, those sports go. Do you commit to opening yourself up completely to her and share with her your entire being, to share in the laughter as well as the tears, to love and to cherish her until death or zombies do you part? That'll move the chains. Womp womp. May have the bride's ring. John, please place this ring on Shelby's finger and repeat after me. Shelby, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love, and that I am choosing to share my life journey with you. I give you this ring with the pledge to love you today, tomorrow.
I give you this ring.
With the pledge to love you. Today, tomorrow, always, and forever.
Today, tomorrow, always, and forever.
You've both chosen to wear rings as a reminder of these promises. People often say wedding bands are a perfect circle with no beginning nor end. But these rings did have a beginning. The stones were formed a long time ago deep within the earth. Eventually, a series of lucky events caused them to rise to the surface, where men dug them up. Men who discovered the wheel and invented the Eiffel Tower out of metal and bronze. The metal was then liquefied in a furnace of 1,000 degrees, molded, cooled, and painstakingly polished. Something beautiful was made from these raw elements. Love is like that. It comes from humble beginnings, and through a combination of serendipity and effort, imperfect beings shape it into something extraordinary. It's a process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. And as you look at these rings over the years, I hope you remember that. You've created something invaluable, and just as I know you'll protect these rings, I'm confident you'll protect these commitments that you made for one another today. By the power vested in me by the American Marriage Ministries in the state of North Carolina, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
for this wide-eyed wanderer.
Yeah! That's a good moment. That's a good moment.
Shelby.